This is sort of a tricky question, so if you guessed, I don't blame you. The correct answer is number two, that what you want to do is be open to different number of principal components being relevant to you. And the way that you figure out sort of what that trend is just by trying different numbers. You say, just give me the first principal component, the first plus the second, the first plus the second plus the third, and you watch how the accuracy responds to these increasing numbers of principal components. You can also do this in just plain old feature selection as well. You say, give me all the features in the order of their importance, and I'm just going to try adding them one at a time and see how the accuracy responds, and cut off when it seems like it's plateauing. One thing you don't want to do, though, is performing feature selection before you go into PCA. So remember, PCA is going to find a way to combine information from potentially many different input features together. So if you're throwing out input features before you do PCA, you're throwing out that information that the PCA might be able to kind of rescue in a sense. It's fine to do feature selection on the principal components after you've made them, but you want to be very careful about throwing out information before you perform PCA. That having been said, PCA can be fairly computationally expensive. So if you have a very large input feature space and you know that a lot of them are potentially completely irrelevant features, go ahead and try tossing them out, but proceed with caution.